bring out the truth of the Bible and you compare it to the things that are going on today, it should make you grasp to it more and gravitate onto it more. And then to understand that this is your God, good night. What more has to be said? How much more bloodshed? How much more diseases, man? The Lord is trying to protect you. Give him a reason to protect you, man. And he gonna do his fatherly duty and pursue you and show you Exodus 15:3.
If you can't tell by now, the men in the ISU became our prophets. What that brother just said is absolutely heavy, man. What he just said is heavy, man. Right now, the Lord is turning his face back to his children. He's not all the way looking, but he's turning his face, and right now, the earth is in panic, man. Man, listen, blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, you gotta understand something. We have a God, and we gotta serve our God. But look, man, we are the Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge, started out of 1 West, 125th Street, out of Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yahada, man. We are not affiliated with no other Israelite group or Christian organization, man. We come out here to teach the truth according to this Bible. This Bible prophesied there will be plagues in America. This Bible prophesied there will be panic all over the earth. And guess what? Look what's happening. DC is empty. I don't think it's been this empty after 9/11. DC is empty. You know why? Because the Lord is punishing the earth. The Lord is punishing America, man. The Lord is punishing America for their crimes and their treatment against his children. Who are the Lord's children? Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Give me Exodus 3 and 9, man. The Lord is punishing this wicked place because of how they treat blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. If you didn't know, we're the Lord's children. We are the real Jews according to the Bible. We are special according to the God of the Bible. Guess what he's showing us? He is creating a separation between us and everybody else. And that separation is through the coronavirus. That's one of the few ways. It's going to be more. The brother just said something absolutely heavy, man. Most High in Christ, man. He said the Lord is peeking right now. And look what's going on. Look what's going on. The Lord is showing us some favor. And he's peeking. And right now the earth is in panic from a goddamn cough and sneeze. This kingdom is so fragile, yet they're so arrogant when the Lord can end all this so easily. Tell them where you at.
I got the book of Exodus, chapter 3, verse 9. Now, therefore, behold, the cry of the children of Israel.
The Bible is saying, now, behold, the cry of the children of Israel. Who are the children of Israel? Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. I know it doesn't seem like it's true, because right now there's a people that claim to be the children of Israel, that claim to be the real Jews. But guess what? According to this book, the real Jews are blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And the Bible is saying the cry of his children, the cry of the Hispanic children that's in cages, the cry of the black men that's locked up in prison, the cry of the 70,000 black women that's missing, that cry has gone up unto the Lord. Read it again from the top.
Verse 9. Now therefore, behold, the cry of the children of Israel is come unto me.
The Lord said the cry of the children of Israel has come up to me. Meaning black people crying, black mothers mourning the death of their children by police. They just had the police shoot a young brother in Raleigh, North Carolina. How much more has to happen? 7 times in the back. From stealing a pizza. 7 times in the back. You know why? Because America hates the Lord's children. And America doesn't think nobody is going to come to our rescue. America can respect the Chinese because the Chinese have an army to defend them. The America can respect the Arabs because the Arabs have an army to defend them. America can respect every other race of people because they have people to defend them. Guess what, black man? Guess what, Hispanic man? Guess what, Native American Indian man? Our army is in this book. Our army is the only army we need, and that's the Most High power of this Bible. And he's in the virus, man. The Lord sent this virus, man. You know why? Because he has heard our cries. The Lord has heard us suffer in America. The Lord has heard us crying out to Him after we work 12-hour shifts and we come home and have to go to another job just to barely make it, just to suffer some more, just to not be able to raise our children, just to have to suffer under these devils who have no compassion, no mercy, no sense of humanity. I pray the Lord sends the coronavirus to all these devils, man. I pray the Lord plagues your children and your children's children. You know why? Because you never respected our pain. You never respected our suffering. You multiplied our suffering, man. Read.
And I have also seen the oppression with what the Egyptians oppressed them.
Read that again, man. Read that again. It's something we have to understand about this Bible. This Bible is not only black people's history, but this Bible repeats itself, meaning what's going on right here in the Bible is going on right now. You know why? Because this book is alive. This, the God of this Bible is real. All the Muslims right now are in their houses. The Muslims every year are supposed to go to a pilgrimage to circle around the Kaaba stone and kiss some goddamn rock. Well, how I help you? Are the Muslims in Mecca right now? You know, no, they're not. They're in their homes. You know why? Because Allah has no power. Allah is not real. Where's Buddha? Where's Buddha at to save all these Chinese people? Nowhere. You know why? Because their God is not real. None of the gods that everybody claim to have is real except the God of this book. And He loves His children. And He has heard the oppression that we are suffering under the Egyptians, man. The Lord is hearing us suffer in America, man. The Lord is hearing the brother that is suffering in jail for being locked up for something he didn't do. Listen, the Lord hears the cries of Nathaniel Woods, man. The Lord hears the cries of Emmett Till. The Lord hears the cries of Sandra Bland. Of all our dead, man. Guess what? You don't have to care. The God of the Bible cares. And if you can't tell by now, He's showing us He cares. He's showing us He still cares. He reads.
And I have also seen the oppression with what the Egyptians oppressed them.
Who are the modern day Egyptians? If you gotta understand history, there you go, you just said it, sis. The white man. Go ahead, Cap.
Yeah, you, okay, you, now listen. You come over here, let me talk to you. Come over here, let me talk to you. Right here.